Red Cadillac goes up now, and the line is complete. The red light, it blinks on top of the starting gates. He has the button. The all clear has been given. They're off and racing. Dream Evil, Scorpion Storms. They were the last to go. Scorpion Storms seemed to dip shortly after they landed. And Testing Love went right back toward the tail as well. But Buster's Force got out like a shot for the Pontiff and landed straight in front from On Red Alert. Going forward, Billy Jack. Over on the inside is Wonderkind. A length away, Kazaku, as they settle properly into stride. Now picking up good ground after that tardy beginning. Scorpion Storms in front of Dream Evil. And then came after a length, Brave Call, back in the field with Canny Jack, Red Cadillac, and last is the mare Testing Love. At the 700 they go, Buster's Force steady them up, pricked the ears and led a half a length on Billy Jack, which found its way to the girth of the leader. Wonderkind pushing up on the inside, strides to third in front of On Red Alert, who's getting a gun run. A length and a half behind them, Scorpion Storms rolling off the fence in front of Kazaku. Brave Call is next over near the rail, back there with Dream Evil in the middle. Now around the outside, going forward, Canny Jack, Testing Love, found his toe ball, and towards the tail is Red Cadillac. Buster's Force headed for home on Red Alert, let go very quickly. Kazaku, Testing Love, coming down the outskirts of the track inside the 200. Testing Love erupted, and Testing Love storms to the front now, bounds away from Scorpion Storms, Kazaku, but Testing Love's killing them, and Testing Love won it by nearly 3 lengths. Scorpion Storms, Kazaku might have grabbed third in front of the fast finishing Red Cadillac. Canny Jack next home ahead of On Red Alert, followed by Buster's Force. Further back behind those then, pulling up Brave Call. Then came behind those next in is Dream Evil. And the last two home were Wonderkind, and back with it as well as Billy Jack. Smart win this by Testing Love. Produced a very good run on return. No luck second up. Has come from the tail of the field. Testing Love, confident ride. Super confident ride there by Pat Carberry on Testing Love, having her third run for trainer Stephen Rowe, and has absolutely blown them away. Testing Love first, Scorpion Storm second, and Kazaku holds third in front of Red Cadillac, who picked up many lengths late. 4-2-8-11 in 124-24. And it's 3 lengths by 3/4. Testing Love by Ifraj out of Test Case. And she went to the stable of Steve Rowe with a great pedigree behind her. Ms. T. Linden, Ms. L. Linden, the owners. Pat Carberry in the saddle, home in 35.97. Her fourth win from 11, her first for Stephen Rowe. And her third run the campaign. And the way that she put them away there, she's got more in store. Scorpion Storms didn't get the best of the starts and then just seemed to land a little awkwardly. By Ukbar from Northerly Gale, second up, finishes second for Josh Crispin, ridden by Lakdar Romilly. And in third placing, number 8, Kazaku by Bradbury's Luck from Zell Vidar, trained by Jason Miller and ridden by Clint Johnston Porter. But a big finishing run, and she got right towards the crown of the course, in fact beyond that, surging, and she made an absolute mozzer of it here in race number 6. The last event, the C-Corp Handicap at 5 o'clock. It's over 1,800, and Chris Parnham will ride number 2, Shadow Girl, here in the lucky last. As we head down to Brittany, about to catch up with Steve Rowe, and she produced a really good run first up, but she had the wind taken out of her sails at a second run in the campaign, and she more than made amends for that this afternoon.
Did indeed. No Steve Rowe on course. Haven't spotted him here today, but a wonderful victory by the mare Testing Love. Scott, and one that we know, an ex-Peters Investments horse, and was picked up in that dispersal sale. And it was a dispersal sale with a bit of a difference, this one, because from memory, she wasn't one that went through the Magic Millions sale, but rather when basically it was put in your bid and we'll see what it is. We don't actually know what she was purchased for, but a handy acquisition regardless.
set up as a tender process, Britt. So you basically put in your bids and had a time period to get there, and then it went through to Peter's Investments. And yes, a mare by Ifrage who ends up with Stephen Rowe. And the first up run was incredible. We talked about that, and the format of it's been super. We saw Warm and Fuzzy last Saturday win, and we saw Cross Statement on Saturday win as well. And then second up, copped a little bit of interference at about the 900 or 800 metre marker and got a really bad squeeze and a bump, and nothing really went right. So that beaten margin was highly inflated. And as we talked about numerous times in that preview, Britt, the form behind Snipperucci we've seen so far now, five horses come from it. We saw Speed Dream win on Sunday. We saw Dunbar run second. We've seen Testing Love win. Scorpion Storms run second. And the market mover, there in On Red Alert, who's missed the money, but the plunge goes amiss there. So five horses out of it, two wins, two seconds, two Quinellas. Yeah. It's been very, very good form. And we see Snipperucci on Saturday, so we'll definitely be following her. But Paddy Carberry, I'm sure, can give us a bit of an insight into the interference that she copped last start. But today, getting to the outside, she erupted at the top of the home straight. She won it by three lengths in the end. 4, 2, 8, and 11. Paddy Carberry's waiting patiently in line to weigh in, and then we'll get a word.
We will indeed. An effortless victory today down the outside. She put the afterburners on to just career away from them. A good margin there in the finish for Testing Love. So good acquisition for the Stephen Rowe yard. They've picked up a mare from the Peter's Investments livery, and Paddy Carberry will give us more insight with Scott.
Well, Paddy, we were just talking about the interference that she copped last start in that race behind Snipperucci. It looked as though she got a really big squeeze, and then from there just ended up in a different sort of race to the rest of them.
Yeah, she was sort of just struggling to handle the pace of that Saturday class over 1200, and the horse on the inside just wanted to run off the track and just took her straight across hills, and it did knock her right off balance, and at the same time they just quickened, and she really probably lost two or three lengths. So for her to gather herself, you know, in the straight and finish off a little bit, I thought it was a good run. Obviously dropping a lot in grade, and the stepping up to the 7 furlongs was a big plus.
Looked like you were full of confidence there, a fair way from home too.
Well, she's a horse that has a bit of wind issue, and I found that horses that have that sort of trouble, you can't pull them around too much and you can't urge them too much early. And I just obviously drew wide, so just sort of let it unfold, but I was able to get on the back of Sean O'Donnell, and he was just bringing us into the race beautifully. And yeah, she let down with a good kick, actually.
That was the second leg of a double. Can you make it a treble with Groundbreaker in the last?
Well, he done a good job last start. He's obviously goes up a little bit in weight, but he couldn't do any more than what he done the other day. He's obviously been a bit of an unfamiliar role to him last time, but I'd say he'd be on the speed somewhere, and you know, if he brings his same form to the races, he should be a good chance.
I'm sure you were proud of your mate Safari, who kicked home his first winner at Ascot in the most recent event.
Yeah, it was really good to see. I was a bit worried that he might grab the iPad and you know, get on the Safari, but he's kept himself in the zone, and it's all good.
Best of luck for the last.
Cheers, mate.
There is Paddy Carberry after the win of Testing Love. One more to come here from Ascot.